Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. In today's video, we will be making some pasta, but with this pasta, we are using the Hillshire Farm beef smoked sausage. I am using 1.5 pack of that, and I already went ahead and chopped it up. And you are going to be needing half a red bell pepper, half a green bell pepper, and I have half a large onion chopped up, and I am using 1.5 tablespoon of olive oil. And you are going to be needing some butter, and you are needing some nutmeg. If you have some fresh nutmeg, you can go ahead and grate yours. I'm using some sun-dried tomatoes, and you already know I am using the Slap Your Mama seasoning. If you have any other type of Cajun seasoning, you can use that instead. You are going to be needing some heavy whipping cream, and I am using some Gouda cheese. This is one Gouda cheese I went ahead and grate. This is what it looks like from the store, okay? But you can use any white cheese that you want. And I'm using 1 cup of penne pasta. This is what the pasta look like. And of course, you are going to be needing some water to cook your pasta and some salt and pepper to taste. Please check the description box where I will list everything I use in this video. So let's get cooking, guys. You want to go ahead and cook your pasta according to the package instruction, but I like to add a little bit of salt to my water just so I can flavor my pasta. So now I have this stove set on medium high. You want to go ahead and put a little bit of olive oil, not too much. And now we are going to brown our sausage, okay? Just so we can get a nice color in them. By the way, guys, my kids love this pasta recipe so much that they really wanted me to share it with you guys. And I think my son is going to try to do a YouTube video remaking this recipe. That's how much they like it. Again, I'm going to try to get a nice little caramelization on each of these sausages, even if it's just one side. It's okay. So allow it to cook for a few minutes without turning them. And then once one side is cooked, we can go ahead and flip them to the other side. As you can see, my sausage is nice and brown. So I'm going to go ahead and remove it. Okay. Place it on another bowl. And of course, they have all that little extra oil, the sausage oil, plus some of the oil that I added. So you are going to go ahead and dump that into a plate. We are not going to be using that. And you are going to save the nice stuff that the pasta left behind, or not the pasta, that the sausage left behind. And now you want to go ahead and add your butter and add the onion. I am so excited to eat this. And now we are going to cook this until they are nice and tender, but we don't want to overcook them at all, okay? So this might take a couple minutes to do. And now you want to go ahead and add that sun-dried tomato and let that cook together for a couple more minutes. And to that, I'm going to add a little bit of salt just so I can season the vegetables and a little bit of black pepper, okay? And let that cook for a good 3 to 5 minutes. And now you want to go ahead and add that heavy whipping cream. If you want, you can definitely use chicken broth and just mix the two. But for this, I'm only using strictly heavy whipping cream. And now we are going to season our sauce. So I'm going to put some of the Slap Your Mama seasoning. Remember, we already put a little bit of salt already. Okay. stir everything up and make sure you taste. Make sure it's flavorful. And I am going to put a little bit of that nutmeg. Not much. That's Jamal laughing because he's trying to study the recipe so they can remake it. I'm going to add just a little more of that Slap Your Mama. Make sure you taste your food, guys. And now let this cook for about 3 to 4 minutes. So now you want to turn that heat down to about a medium or medium low. And now we are going to return the pasta with all the drippings. I keep saying pasta. You are going to return the sausage. I'm not sure why I keep calling the sausage pasta, but return the sausage with all the dripping. That looks and smells so good already. And of course you are going to taste, because you know that sausage have a little bit of salt. Still tasting mighty good. When I make these videos, I want to make sure I go step by step so you guys can really see what's going on, so you guys can really do it easy at your own home. Now we are going to go ahead and add the pasta. And mix everything. If you feel like you don't have enough liquid, you can always warm up some of that half and half, okay, and add to it. But I feel like mine is pretty good. And now I'm going to add that cheese. I love the taste of the Gouda cheese. They have a little smoky flavor to it, which just make everything about this recipe so good. I forgot to mention, if you have a little fresh parsley, you can definitely use it just to make your plates pretty after it's done cooking. You can see how gooey all that cheese is. It's so good. And this one, we don't have to bake this one under the oven. This is good as it is. Okay. Look at this, guys. Look at how gooey. Delicious. All right. And that's pretty much it. Again, you can use some fresh parsley just to pretty up your plate, which I will do. And I will do a picture at the end so you guys can see. But this is pretty much it. I'm going to taste a piece of that pasta just to make sure all that flavor is in there as well. It's like a cheesy goodness over here. But hopefully you guys enjoyed this video. Please don't forget to subscribe to the channel, comment, like, and share. As always, please stay safe. And I love you guys for watching. See you on my next video. Bye-bye.